Can you have Sjogren's disease without positive antibodies? This is a frequent question that many people ask me after seeing the videos in my channel about Sjogren's disease.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
I am Dr. Diana Girnita, a board-certified rheumatologist and autoimmune expert. More than 1.5 million people have watched my videos about Sjogren's disease, and I'm very, very grateful that I was able to help all of you understand this disease better. But today I will answer this question. Can you have Sjogren's disease without positive SSA or SSB antibodies? First, let's quickly review the diagnostic criteria for Sjogren's disease. In 2016, the American College of Rheumatology and the European Alliance of Rheumatology came with a new set of classification criteria. Based on this, to be diagnosed with Sjogren's, you need a total score of 4 or more points from various tests and different other factors. But this will include a positive lip biopsy, which will give you 3 points, or a positive SSA antibody test, which will also give you 3 points. Other tests like eye dryness exams or saliva production test can also give you 1 point for each. The key thing to note here is that positive antibodies are not mandatory for diagnosis under this new criteria. You can still meet the requirement with a combination of these positive tests. So, can people actually have Sjogren's without antibodies like anti-SSA or anti-SSB? And my answer is yes, definitely. As I discussed in another video that you can watch here, when I have a patient that comes to me with complaints of dry eyes, dry mouth, or other complaints like severe fatigue, dry skin, vaginal dryness, joint pain, lymph nodes that are enlarged, headaches, signs of neuropathy or headaches, I do run a large battery of autoimmune tests that will include an ANA test, SSA, SSB, rheumatoid factor, CCP antibodies, CBC, which will evaluate for anemia, for low white blood cells, a CMP or a metabolic panel to evaluate their liver or kidney function. I will also obtain complement levels like C3, C4. I will obtain a serum electrophoresis, but also I will test the patient for hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and sometimes for TB or HIV. So, as you can see, I will make a very comprehensive approach. However, there are patients that will test negative for SSA and SSB antibodies, and there are also patients that will test negative for ANA. And this is a very common test used when we screen for autoimmune diseases. So, just because the ANA is negative, I do not stop there. I usually order ANA plus SSA and SSB. A 2021 study found that about 8% of Sjogren patients have negative SSA, SSB, rheumatoid factor antibodies, but they have a positive ANA test. And surprisingly, 4.5% were negative for all of them. Negative for SSA, SSB, rheumatoid factor, and ANA. Now, more recently, a 2023 study looked at more than 900 Sjogren patients and found out that 32% were negative for both SSA and SSB antibodies. So clearly, having negative antibody results does not rule out Sjogren's. This 2023 study also noted some very interesting differences between people that had antibody positive and people that were antibody negative in that population of Sjogren patients. In that group of antibody negative patients, there were more males, about 90% were males, compared to 76 that were females, and they were in the antibody positive group. They also found out more frequent abnormal results on the Schirmer test, which is the test that will measure dryness. Actually, 96% of antibody negative patients had an abnormal Schirmer test versus just 89% in the antibody positive group. Now, more than that, the antibody negative group had much higher rates of interstitial lung disease at 59%, while only 28% in the group that had antibody positive patients. And this is very important because if you have shortness of breath or severe fatigue, you will need extra testing with pulmonary function test and even more with a CT high resolution to evaluate you for possible interstitial lung disease. So in summary, not only that you can have Sjogren's disease without positive antibodies, but if you are antibody negative, you may actually have a different presentation, different clinical symptoms. For example, you might have a predisposition to have more lung involvement. And to wrap things up, the key takeaway here is that you absolutely can have Sjogren's syndrome even if your antibody tests like anti-SSA or anti-SSB come back negative. The diagnosis of Sjogren's disease remains complex and it is based on a combination of criteria, and positive antibodies are helpful, but they are not strictly required. And this is especially important for males who, again, can be more likely to be antibody negative, but they can still develop Sjogren's disease. So if you have symptoms like severe dryness in the eyes, in the mouth, don't get discouraged if you have negative antibodies. Make sure to discuss all the testing options with your rheumatologist. And now that I answer this question and you learn about the fact that you can still have Sjogren's disease without positive antibodies, you should continue to watch this video where I discuss about the most updated treatments for Sjogren's disease.
Rheumatologistoncall.com